Hi dear friends, analysis of English. This is one of the reasons why you fear speaking in English. We do analysis of English. It's like we are studying as if we are studying a subject. I will give you one example of that. How analysis of English stops you from speaking. I'll give you one example from my real life. I'm from Marathi medium school, I have told you many times. Now here, one day I was, I was in 7th standard, and in that session, first time Marathi grammar subject was introduced. And one new teacher came from another school, from the same campus, but from another school. I think he was teaching for seniors. He came and he taught us Marathi grammar. Well, he made one table, a big table was there, and he took one sentence and he put that sentence into all the 5, 7, 8 columns were there. One sentence was broken into one part, it was put in another column and another column. This he taught us nearly 2 hours. And after 2 hours, I was confused. And I asked my friends. They were also confused. And so we couldn't understand what is going on there. But one thing I realized that Marathi is also a very difficult language. And I was shocked that how am I speaking so nicely? In fact, the analysis of Marathi language created fear in me. And for next 10 to 15 days, I was very nervous while speaking in Marathi also. And this is exactly what happens with English. When you do analysis of English, you become paralyzed. Why? Because while speaking, if we do too much analysis of each and every word, each and every sentence, as if we are solving a maths problem or any physics problem, then you become conscious while speaking. And when you're speaking consciously, you don't speak naturally. Because native speakers, natural speakers, don't speak consciously. They speak unconsciously or naturally. Let me give you one example now. See here, what are you interested in? Are you interested in using a mobile? Or are you interested in understanding how the mobile works? Well, I can give you one more. Are you interested in understanding how a bike works? Or are you interested in driving? One more I can give. Are you interested in how a plane flies? Or are you interested in traveling? See here, what I want to say is this. Are you interested in speaking? Or are you interested in analysis of the language? That's the question. If you are preparing for any grammar exam, if you are preparing for any exam where analysis of language is required, then definitely do it. But if you are speaking for expressing yourself, if you are speaking for giving a message, if your purpose is this, then you don't need to do any analysis. And if you do that, you will be paralyzed. You will get paralysis of a language. Paralysis of a language means you are constantly aware of what you are speaking. You're constantly checking your English, you're constantly checking your grammar, you're constantly checking your pronunciation. Everything is conscious. And consciously, language never develops. Look at your mother tongue. Your mother tongue has been developed unconsciously. So stop doing this. Stop being so conscious and just focus on expressing yourself. Don't go and study how a language works, like how a bike works. Just focus on what you want. And what you want is use a language as a tool. That's all, nothing else. So stop analysis and start speaking naturally, confidently, and fluently. Bye-bye. Thank you.